Hi, I'm Mark Levitt, and welcome to another exciting episode of Bad Lyrics. Today, my focus is the inimitable Paul McCartney. Paul McCartney and his bad lyrics. So here we go. Welcome to this adventure. Okay, so now my focus is Paul McCartney, and picking a bad Paul McCartney lyric is a lot like shooting fish in a barrel. He has so many. Really, a lot of bad lyrics. True, he was part of the most successful groups in recording history with the Beatles and John Lennon, of course. But when the Beatles disbanded, songwriting gifts, such as they were, became atrophied. With Wings and his subsequent solo efforts, they became increasingly nauseatingly sappy and irrelevant. So that's what I'm going to look at today. And don't talk to me about Maybe I'm Amazed. That always sounded to me like a leftover Beatles song anyway. Maybe I'm Amazed is a good song, but it sounded like he just didn't get to put that on the last Beatles album and just plunked it down on the first solo album he released. So anyway, let's not talk about that. Okay. So, no doubt Paul McCartney can do some catchy melodies, musical riffs, and choruses that won't leave your head unless you get a lobotomy. But every post-Beatles song he's written, to me, sounds as insipid as the Beatles' worst song, or one of their worst songs, Octopus's Garden, by, who wrote it, George? So it sounds as ridiculously weak as that, to me. You could disagree, of course, but it's a lot of similarity. Okay, anyhow, look at his songs. Look at them. Wonderful Christmas Time, Spies Like Us, Say, 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 Pipes of Peace. Hearing a medley of these songs would be like someone swinging a lead pipe over your head and then pouring acid in your ears. Not a good feeling. A very bad. His message songs, like Ebony and Ivory, for racial equality, are nauseating. Or Tug of Peace. Really? Tug of Peace? That's the name of the song, Tug of Peace? More like Rest in Peace. Anyhow, and most of Paul McCartney's post-Beatles songs sound like they were written by a six-year-old girl. They sound as weak as that. I mean, look, listen to the lyrics of So Bad. Let's read them. Let's read the lyrics and see if you agree, okay? Girl, I love you. Girl, I love you so bad. Well, it feels so good. Sometimes it feels so bad. This is worse than anything I've ever had. So here Paul McCartney is describing the way he feels toward a girl as both good and bad. I mean, this profound Beatle has cracked the code for male and female relationships. He has. They have good aspects, but now here's the tricky part. They also have bad. I mean, here my mind is officially blown. I mean, I feel disoriented. I'm not sure who or what I am. He's officially blown my mind. I mean, what if Paul McCartney had written a song about water and described it as being sometimes hot and sometimes cold? Well, then, I don't know what I would have done with myself. I'd have to reassess my whole life, I think, in that case. Or how about the insipid irrelevance of the song Let Him In. Let's read the lyrics to that song. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay? Someone's knocking at the door. Someone's ringing the bell. Do me a favor. Open the door and let him in. How about doing us a favor, McCartney? Okay? And trying to write some lyrics that actually have a point to them. Do us a favor. I mean, I can write a song, too, about replacing a roll of toilet paper, but I'm not sure anybody wants to hear that. Or maybe they do. So maybe I should start singing it. Okay, let's go. Okay. No TV left on the roll. must take a dump real bad. No TP left on the roll, and I'm feeling real sad. Do me a favor, toss me a roll, so I can wipe. Yeah, yeah, I can really wipe away. All right. No one wants to hear that. Okay. Or what about the song Average Person? Okay, here's a real winner here. Average Person, where Paul McCartney clumsily tries to put himself in the shoes of the average person. Listen to these lyrics. Well, I'm talking to a former engine driver, trying to find out what he used to do. Tells me that he always kept his engine spit and polished up as good as new. But he said his only great ambition was to work with lions in a zoo. So McCartney, always curious. He's a curious George. He starts, you know, asking questions about probably his own limo driver. Guy can't leave his car. So he's asking questions about his limo driver. He's curious about what the limo driver wanted to do with his life, and finds out his life ambition was to be a zoo attendant. Okay, well, now I'm not knocking the man's dream. If he wants to clean up lion turd, that's his privilege. But this character study is something tantamount to what a second grader might turn in as a lesson, you know? This is a penetrating character insight. I mean, what kind of simplistic lyrics are these? Please. I mean, McCartney is clearly a world-traveled man, a former Beatle, knighted by the Queen of England. Can he dig a little deeper here? I mean, these lyrics sound like something Lenny from Of Mice and Men would have written. You know, what are we going to expect next? Can we pet the rabbits, George, as a song? I don't know. Well, that's been it for today's edition of Bad Lyrics, featuring the awful, the weak, the simplistic, the nauseatingly banal lyrics of Paul McCartney. Enjoy.